Does anybody have a social media account or ever have one? Did you know that social media is an ideal place for criminals to receive personal info about anyone? Social sites make it easier for criminals to get info because they can disguise themselves behind a computer screen. For example, I had a friend Trey, or he's my teammate, and we were in Michigan in November for our first game. And we had a little bit of free time at the hotel and stuff, and he was on Tinder. And Tinder is a social media site that you can meet people and you press a heart button, that means you like them, you press an X button, that means you don't want to talk to them. But if you both press the heart button, then you both can talk to each other and hang out or link up. So he started talking to a girl named Kaylin, and they started talking and started connecting. And then he invited her to our game the next day. So we get to the game, and after the game, he was looking for her. And he and a random girl came up, and she was like, "Hi, I'm Kaylin." And then he's looking at her like, "No, you're not. Like, this is not what it says on Tinder." But it wasn't her. It was someone else posing as another girl. So that's a way that social media can disguise itself behind the screen. Another way social media involves crime is cybercrime. And the vast majority of it includes like identity theft, data mining, phishing schemes, and fraud. And, you know, like companies and employees, they use social media too because they want to advertise and get the word out, stuff like that. But that makes them vulnerable by exposing their company to cybercrime threats. Another way that social media and crime evolve each other is children. And I see it while we're at basketball camps that children, when we have breaks or water breaks or anything like that, or lunch breaks, they go and get their phone immediately, and they start playing on it. They start getting on Instagram and Facebook and Twitter, and like I said in the beginning, that people can disguise themselves as children and lure them in. So to conclude, social media has many opportunities to create crime, including posing as someone else, affecting the economy, and the risk of children exploitation. Thank you.